We're not here 10 minutes, we haven't even got the tent up. George, I said two fish and just missed two. And there's an orange bubble float out there, which isn't George's, by the way. George, there's three fish out of this bit. Two in there. And one just over there. You know, obviously somebody hasn't read the rules. There's a wee orange bubble float lying out there. Fish turn just over there. There are a couple rising round about this bubble float, so see what appears. Far side. Plenty of fish moving anyway. Oh, another one over there. And another one. No shortage of rising fish. They're just a wee bit too far out. Move down here a bit and see what happens, and what happens. Fish rises down there where I just left. Never mind. Plenty of fish rising, so still one more chance. Surrounded with fish. Always wait until you're doing something else and then rise. Good grief. Oh, for goodness sake. Looks like the rain's moving in. No cloud. Again. Rain all day yesterday, howling gales. Never got out of the tent once we got them up. We just got them up and the rain came on and that was it for the day. A couple of ravens up there somewhere. Sounds like a creaking door. George back. Tell me he's only four now. Me? Still on blank. Oh, I missed one in a hillock nymph further back. Felt it jag and then off. I never caught in on this one. Plenty of fish, we'll come back. Rain's come on. This place isn't squelchy enough. catching more wind on this one. The tents look quite inviting, don't they?
Look inviting to the point where I'm not going to lie down again.
Come up and take the dry fly, George. George, could you come and give me a hand? There's two here. George, I've got two on. Could you give me a hand? I can't get them on. Come here. Trying to get them on. Here. There's one on the tail. Right, see, look. it goes and the other one goes with it. Lively wee things. Just wind your finger, that other one's pulling. You'd be better grabbing a hold of the other one, because that's pulling the hook. The other one's a better fish. This one here's a better fish, it looks like.
That's a far better fish. That's a cracker. That's the biggest up to now.
Yep.
That's bigger than the ones I've caught. Jesus, that's a beauty. Beautiful. Beautiful.
Take that out, will you? Okay.
Beautiful.
Yep.
Storm of the fish.
Oh, get in.
I'll find his own way. To the end of the bank.
Yep.
Try to grab that for a minute.
What? A lava. Another one, half a pound. That'll make up for the one that you missed the last time.
What's that?
That'll make up for the one you missed there a wee while ago. Squelchy. Foul hooked, doesn't count. That one was on the size 12 hull lock nymph again.
Do you want to start fishing up here?
Well, not at the present moment. You sure you haven't got two on there? Size of the supports on them things. Yeah, 3/4, George, please.
First shot, I was in the camera, sorry.
There's no shortage of fish rising anyway. Yes. They're not taking off the surface, so they're taking from underneath. There's only the odd one or two's taking the surface one. Look to me as if they're moving about though. They're not static in the one place. One row is just to the right. Just a bit level with your fly now. I think that one's too far out.
That was a nice fish spot.
And that one's a wee bit too far as well. And that one's just in the right hand side of your fly. Oh, and that one, you took it out of its mouth. Did you see that?
What's
that? It rose just as you took the fly out of the water. many is that you've had now? Is that six?
We would never have been starving.
Pan size. Orvis pheasant tail. Oh, they're on the nymphs. They're taking the odd fly on the surface, but it's nearly all the nymphs they're taking. The lines are just a wee bit too far out. The wee one took the hillock nymph just off that weed bed there.